see everything's the same.
I can feel it, you know? Like it's got some kind of power.
It's a beautiful stone.
The place looks 100 years old.
Mm-hmm. The guard's 100 years old.
The day guard, you mean? They make it look easy, don't they, those sly bastards?
Hey, babe, this is crazy. I mean, even to think about it's crazy.
And I love it.
Closing up, folks, if you don't mind.
Yes, sir, we'll be right with you.
Can you imagine the largest ruby in the world, the largest sapphire in the world, the largest black sapphire in the world? And they have them labeled like little toothbrushes with tiny nameplates. It's incredible. People don't even realize what's in this place.
They will tomorrow. Night, thank you.
Yes, sir, good night.
Too many times. You even talked to a guard today.
So what are you doing here?
We're partners, man. I know how much this means to you.
Doing it all for me, huh? What does Jack Murphy want with the star of Minnie? The only thing bugs you is no one's gonna know that we got it.
Yeah, there's ways of getting the word around.
And getting caught. You got big mouth, Murphy, you know that?
Yeah, well, I'm not stupid.
About some things.
Hey, what are you talking about last night? Let's keep my love life out of this. Nothing to do with what we're here for. Got a big mouth, Murphy, and you know it. Yeah, you better cut this crap cure. It's gonna be all over between us.
Then you won't have to go in downstairs. You're the one that's worried about getting busted.
Yeah, you son of a bitch. If there was 100 cops down there, it goes through that window, and you know it.
Yeah, I guess maybe you would. Weird, Murphy, weird.
Go ahead.
Let's have a look.
Let's have a look around.
What happened to Sylvia?
No, not what happened.
She ran away with
me. You mean Max the accountant?
Yeah,
Max the accountant.
Oh, one of the
dogs on here, yeah.
Did I get you wet?
Sorry. It's all right. I'm dressed for it.
Well, I noticed that amongst other things.
Like what?
The way your uniform fits. Very fine, love.
It's none of your business.
Are you going to be around a while?
Mm-mm. I'm transferring to San Francisco next week.
Oh.
Hey. How do you know how my uniform fits?
Well, none of your business.
You wouldn't lie to me, would you?
Anything to please me.
Where's Alan?
Alan? Here someplace. I just saw him.
Well, we had a swimming lesson at 3.
Oh. Oh, well. Will I do?
No.
Hey, man, close the damn door, will you?
I'm sorry.
Nice to meet you.
Would you, lock the door, please?
Good looking, that's all you get.
What's that?
Little clock on the wall.
Oh.
Hey, thank you.
You're very welcome. 5 o'clock?
Why not?
Did anybody hear what's with the weather up north?
Yeah, Eli called me last night. He said it was freezing up in New York.
They exaggerate. It's not so freezing up in New York.
What do you mean?
I saw a friend.
I believe I'm sure it was my son-in-law, and he said they put two blankets.
Really? Oh, yeah.
What do you mean? Get out of here.
I'm going to try
to
dump myself.
I'm
trying to
carry you. You girls play hard, please. I mean, I've got that hard.
Okay, Jim.
Get tired of this place?
What do you want for 100 a quarter, Jack?
Well, that's not bad. Still, you gotta fix it up with some... Buy yourself some furniture.
Keep thinking I'm gonna move, man.
Yeah, I've been thinking the same thing.
Now that I can, pay the rent.
Dirty jewel thief. What put you out of the score in the first place?
Some guy at a bar. Looper, they call him. What do you think the stuff is worth, anyway?
Now, how the hell would I know?
Let me see. It's not bad for stuff. One night's work, I don't know. I guess I'd sell for $5,000.
$5,000? That stuff is any good, Jack. I'll give you $10,000 right now.
What, $10,000? Come on.
Take it or leave it, Jack.
Bullshit.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, Jack.
You playing the poor boy.
It works too, Jack, because nobody knows my name downtown. Nobody.
Well, I'll be a goddamn son of a bitch. You mean there's this kind of money in it?
That's right, Jack.
Alan the Beach Boy, you sly bastard. You, you know that 2 hours ago, man, I was broken. Look at this. $10,000. Oh, Alan, thank you so much.
Yay! I'll give you $20,000.
I was thinking more like $22,000, Max.
I see. Apparently, this is for your benefit. Ordinarily, we don't haggle. Still, we're old friends, and being old friends, from time to time, we indulge one another.
$2,000 for friendship? Since when, Max?
I beg your pardon. Back to 20. I wouldn't want you to feel obligated to me.
Yes, you would. What is it, Max?
there's this this customer I occasionally refer to, the gentleman from Peru. There's a little item he wants. But it's going to take some real nerve.
Then you've come to the right man.
You sure?
I'm sure.
He wants the Star of India.
That's a little piece of New York, Jack, about the size of a golf ball.
563 carats.
Take that thing from a museum? Tell your friend he's out of his mind.
It's between him and his psychiatrist. All I do is handle money. Your share would be considerable.
What the hell does that mean, considerable?
The figure mentioned was 500,000, which could be improved, possibly.
Steal a thing like that? The heat would be tremendous. Hey, come on. You guys have put me on, right?
Are you sure you're the gentleman that's serious? Well, can't hurt to think it over. Count. No refunds after leaving the window.
Thanks, Max. What the hell are you smiling for? I just took it for 10 grand.
of ways of getting even.
Alan.
Hmm?
Alan.
Am I doing something wrong?
Alan, I don't sleep around.
I didn't mean it as a casual thing.
I really didn't. I'm sorry.
Okay. Well, what about Sharon?
She's just a friend. A special friend. Just a friend, that's all.
You have to have more than one.
I wasn't thinking about you as just a friend. I know you met Jack and all. I know you met him first, but... old Jack's always been pretty loose.
Hey, listen, Alan. Jack asked me to move in with him last night. I said yes.
Hey, killer!
In a minute! He moves fast. Here you do. Anyway, somebody does.
Hey, big boy, let's go!
Beach boy, right? Well, what does he do?
He's sort of a dealer in stones. Precious stones. Other people's stones.
You mean he's a jewel thief? Jack too?
Quit the airline, huh?
Yeah, I did.
Well, anytime you want to keep flying, just let me know.
What do you mean?
Well, it takes a lot of spine to be working girl, and I think you got it.
Not like you've got it.
You, got that all figured out too, huh? Yeah, no, well, look, I didn't mean the streets or anything. I'm what you call a highline hooker. Very expensive, by appointment only. I travel around the world. It's a kick, you know?
I imagine so. Except I got one big problem. Nobody's got Jack. Jack's a handful of mercury.
You're no fool either.
Who says?
How'd you find her?
Who, Jenny? She found me.
Why, are you interested? Let me know when you're through with this.
Hey, we're partners.
Partners are equal, right? Now, here in the water, you're the best there is. There's only one Murph to serve.
That's right.
On land, where I operate, he's just not ready yet.
Would it help if I lend you my girl?
I said when you were through with her.
You mean it?
Who are you kidding, Murphy?
Hey, what is that? I gotta tell you, something about her. Alan, gives me a lot of strength, you know? It's a mean,
very, very weird mean. Weird, weird.
Call those feathers an occlusion in the stone, an imperfection that can't be cut out.
Ah. So that means the value's down, right?
That little feather cost me $4,000.
Well, color's still pretty good, isn't it?
I think so, huh? Let me show you something. Come on outside. Sunlight, Murphy. It's the only thing that tells the truth.
Well, it still looks pretty good.
Yeah?
Oh, it's yellow.
Now you got it. It's whiter than sugar, man. You are rich. Penthouse up there. Real estate people. She's got a 51 carat diamond ring, hair shape, that's that big. Woo! Hey, see that house with the big green lawn over there? It's the Cutler Meatpacking Company. 19 carat diamond. Worth $42,000, and a brooch with the finest aquamarines I've ever seen. Surrounded with diamonds, platinum setting, it is a gorgeous piece.
What's that worth?
$100,000. Want it? I'll get it for you.
No. No, thanks. Having a thing like that around would scare me to death.
Hey there. There's a place to stay away from. It's the Stoddard Estate. Incredible security. Incredible. Even the lawn is bugged. I mean it, Jack. Step on the grass, the goddamn bell start ringing.
What's such a big deal? What's inside?
Old man married to a young chick and trying to hang on. A million and a half in jewelry in there and you can't get near it. Old Bester's in love, you know?
Oh.
Collection just grows and grows. She's downtown following a used car salesman.
You know, I mean, this is unreal. It's really unreal. Distort your values a place like this.
Where does it come from? Money. The damn money. Where does it come from?
Who cares? All I know is this is my playground. It goes on for miles, kiddo. Miles and miles and miles.
I like the other one, the red one.
I should take a look at it sometime.
You gotta admit, it's a consolation.
What is?
If we do get caught, we'll lose on top.
telling you, people don't look up. They just don't.
What about the guards? There's guards walking around down there. Did you think about that?
They don't look up either.
You know, talking about it was one thing, but now that we're here, this is crazy, Alan.
I know.
We're going to deliberately break into that thing and set off the alarm.
There's no other way to do it, Murph.
Hey, bells and sirens, who knows what might happen?
Right.
You know, it just hit me. We're going to be insane doing something like this.
But you dig it just like me, right?
What do you think I'm doing here?
Weird.
Give me a
break. Alan?
Yeah?
Alan, this is really a dump.
Working beach boy, right? But I've got some champagne on ice. And some food.
What's that?
Bam!
Oh, come on. What is that? A national debt?
All his, honey. $1,000 bills.
He's in love with that damn box.
Why don't you loosen up a little bit and spend some of that gold?
I'd love to, except how I explain it to the cops.
In this town, who has to explain money?
You might have to. I'm a jewel thief, remember?
Yeah, but who loves it?
Nobody. That's my whole point. I'm one of the top jewel thieves in this town, and the cops don't even know my name.
What a drag. That would drive me nuts.
There's no law against spending money, Alan.
You know those estates we saw today?
I mean, you could buy one of those with this kind of money.
You're rich. Really rich. Now look at the way you live.
Are you worried about going to jail? Come on, rich people don't go to jail.
No, but jewel thieves do, or haven't you noticed? There's no way around it. Sooner or later, we all get busted. It's a fact. Ugly, but it's a fact.
You're just square, Alan.
You think so, huh?
Yeah, you are. You're square. It's your whole trouble.
Let me tell you something. Squares don't pull daylight jobs.
Hey, what do you mean? You got a score in mind?
Big score, but not for you.
What, do you think I'm not ready? Maybe you're not ready.
Did you hear what I said? A daylight job. Broad daylight. On an island crawling with cops. It's gonna take a lot of nerve.
Hey, you're not gonna cut me out, are you, partner?
The windows, bugged. The doors, triple locked.
No problem.
Okay. You can start here with the dresser. Top left-hand drawer, pull it all the way out. And look behind it. 14-carat diamond ring, 7-carat canary, imperial cut. 24,000 right there. Then you go into the closet. Lower right-hand corner, on the shoe rack, pair of ski boots. Platinum, $4,000 wristwatch. And it's engaged. Because I love you, Irene. Now, in the kitchen, in the refrigerator, bottom two ice trays, loaded with a rope of pearls that long. I'm not kidding, $12,000 they paid for. Hey, look, I gotta go sell a guy up in Lauderdale. Have fun, will you? Always do, Buck. I'll hear from you. Hey, you'll hear from me.
You earn a 25%?
Well, I gotta say, it's another big piece. How does he know about all this stuff?
Oh, Bucky there? He handles her insurance.
Oh! Hold it right there, asshole!
Heading south by southwest into this gangway.
Well, they've got a lot of choices.
How'd they get out to us anyway?
Cop? Silent alarm, I guess. Yeah, that's what it had to be.
How come Bucks didn't know about it?
Damn good question. I'm gonna hop all over his ass about it, too.
Don't stick him where it hurts, man. Knock him back down to 10%.
Knock him down anyway, then.
Got him, MPD-4. Quadrant 2. There's a little canal Nelly's way. Got it? Heading north. Suggest you rendezvous Sector 3A with MPD-6 and await his arrival.
Ranger Skipper will do. Captain. Do you mind the helm, will you?
One hardship after another.
You ever been to the Bahamas?
No.
You're going to a beautiful island. But don't unpack. Look around fast, because our departure will be swift.
Hey, Ellen.
Yeah?
What made you finally do it?
Oh, I don't know. I had an urge. Hell, I've always wanted a boat like this. This is a great feeling.
Yeah, but what about cops and questions and all of that?
Like you said, there's no law against spending money.
I'd never worn a fair lady.
Do you think it's like that, huh?
You got something that left out here?
You left that?
Yes, I do.
You do, huh? Yeah, I think I got a cure for that left out.
Is that so?
Yeah, that's so. My name's Mr. Naisby.
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Naisby. Welcome to Bahama Park.
Thank you.
Westminster Suite, sir.
Thank you very much.
Welcome, sir.
Young.
Best wishes from the management staff.
Oh, really? Here. My best wishes.
Thank you, Mr. Naisby. Thank you, Mr. Naisby.
What do you think?
I don't believe this.
It's comfortable.
Hey, something down below caught your eye. What was it?
Only a man could forget.
No, I didn't forget. It was closed.
Yeah.
Spend it all in one place, honey?
She's getting in pretty deep.
Who, Jenny?
Mm-hmm.
What, are you a guardian now?
No. But maybe she needs a guardian. All that strength you're getting from her, it's costing her.
You have a fine understanding of humanity, Alan. I'll tell you what we'll do. When she comes back, we'll sit her down and say, look, Alan and I had a little talk, and we decided that you can only love me so much and then stop. Okay? Now, you can't have her, Alan. I'm not through with her yet.
Just don't rack her up, Jack, that's all.
In the first place, the woman's over 21. In the second place, it's none of your goddamn business.
It isn't why we came here, Murphy. Let's get to it.
Let's get to it.
Thank you. 8. I'll plug it in, will you?
I gotta say, Kieran, it looks like a key to me.
Not a key. A master key. We hit every room in the hotel.
Hey, Alan. Mobile ring.
Jack. Take those suits.
Kuhn?
Yes, sir, that's right.
You're under arrest.
Buddy! How the hell you doing?
Well, heaven's sakes, Murphy. I haven't seen you in a coon's age.
You two guys know each other?
Sure, we played a couple of gigs together in Cincinnati.
Yeah. He played fiddle and I worked the piano.
Oh, Alan Kuhn, Jenny Eaton, Sharon Cagle, Arnie Holcomb.
Special Agent Holcomb. How do you do?
Hey, how the hell you doing, huh?
I can't complain. How about you?
Oh, great. Still married?
Oh, you know we never give up. So where are the goddamn jewels?
Woo! Hey, they got a little huffier.
Marvelous thing, that lack of evidence. Speaking of which, let's go skin diving.
Hey! Woo! Alan! Alan! Save me my place!
You got it, Mrs. Blackton! Harold, did you see that woman there?
Yes, sir.
Give her a pad.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Hey, Alan! Alan!
Yes, sir.
You're Alan Kuhn.
That's right.
That's Bahamas up there that way, huh?
Yeah, about 90 miles.
We'll spend on one place now. Here.
Hey now, Hopper. How's it going?
Your way, I guess, for now. Where'd you get the boat, Alan?
Came in a shoebox.
Big piece of property for a beach boy.
My tips are going way up.
So's your rent, I hear.
Yeah, I got a new address. I feel I earned it.
How, Alan, how?
Had a confession to make. This beach boy bit, it's just a cover.
Alan, you could have fooled me.
I'll tell you the truth. I'm really a salvage diver. Hang in there, Hopper. One of these fine days you're gonna nail me.
I don't think so. You're gonna do it yourself, right to the wall. And when you do, I'm going to be there.
Wait a minute. Are you sure it isn't bugged?
Sure it's bugged.
But not the glass.
This isn't like you, Murphy.
I think just don't like it. Okay, pal, make yourself happy. Maybe you can tell me. I sure as hell don't know. Take your time. I'm in no hurry. You're gonna wake up the dinosaurs.
Anybody coming?
Not yet.
You wanna quit?
Hell no.
Just like a millionaire.
I am a millionaire. Hell, so are you, pal.
Well, now, I'll drink to that.
We're all rich.
Well, almost all of us, anyway.
Ah, as long as I've got it, you've got it. You understand?
Completely.
Hey, working girl. You're flying pretty high. You gonna need that plane?
Oh, my God, the plane. What time is it?
It's time to catch that plane. Mm-hmm.
Eastern's
flight
955
is now
ready for boarding.
I'm not so sure I
want to go. Oh, a little work vacation won't hurt you.
Think about it this way. When you get back, you can afford to buy me a new car.
The way things are going, you ought to buy her one.
Well, yeah, you cheap bastard.
Maybe I will.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eastern's flight 955 to San Juan, Puerto Rico is now ready for boarding.
Now, you behave yourself,
Oh, yeah, sure.
Good. Then I won't have to worry about you.
You know, I think I am going to miss you.
Nothing looks like a surprise.
Just an act.
Come on with the soap opera, huh? Just be gone for a month.
See you, kid. Take care, huh?
Goodbye, baby. Later.
Let's go this way.
What's over there?
The next plane in New York leaves in 20 minutes, and we're going to be on it.
Wait, we're going to go to New York?
They got us 3 tickets, and we can buy whatever we need in New York.
Wait, you're not going after the star, are you?
You know what's in that room? The DeLong Ruby, the Midnight Sapphire, the Eagle Diamond. We're not just going to take the star, Vinny. We're going to clean out the whole place. Biggest score in history. You and me, Murphy.
Oh, come on, you put me on.
Try me.
Man, you're a weird cat.
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Oh, we're going to New York.
God, don't touch me.
Man, nobody wants to touch you. Just show me where the booze goes.
I should imagine the kitchen.
How about starting right here?
Who ordered this? Does anybody know?
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, I'll try one of those.
Well, I don't know. It seems strong.
Excuse me, are you the host?
Oh, no. The host, I think he's over there somewhere.
If I can keep my C average, I got an S, too, so I won't get drafted.
Oh.
Excuse me.
Are you looking for the host?
Yeah, do you know him?
What he looks like, anyway. Come on, we'll find him. 8:11?
Oh, that's right.
Weren't you nervous in front of all those people?
Well, a little bit, but I had a lot going for me. I was playing Mozart.
Carnegie Hall and the whole thing?
West Coast, San Diego, mostly. You know, I keep wondering what you do.
I'm a secretary.
No, I mean in bed.
Oh.
He's just playing games.
Is he now?
Go and do likewise. Just a suggestion.
It's, that one there.
Excuse me, you ordered the booze? Yeah, let me show it quick.
Coming through with the booze.
Excuse me.
There's something about that guy I don't like.
Right here.
The one with my roommate. I saw you watching. I don't like it either.
I guess go here. Would you excuse us, please? Can I get the booze in?
Okay. That comes to $98.46.
Okay. There's the $98.46. So here, see if you can find some use for that one.
Hey, thank you.
Pleasure.
I like a room coke, please.
Hi.
Hi.
How'd you know me?
I live down the hall with Edna.
Oh.
You don't remember.
Must have been some accident. Is that a cross?
Yes.
What'd you say?
No.
You're a good judge of character.
Well, what I actually said was no, not yet. Are you married?
No. No, I am not married.
Got a girl?
No.
Come on. God, like you just gotta have a girl.
You mean girls, don't you? Yeah, I've got a girl. I guess you'd say that. She's in San Juan right now.
Mm. You sure that blonde girl wasn't yours out there?
Jenny? No. Jenny's taken.
Sure she's not your girl?
Yeah, I'm sure. Hey.
Huh?
You know what we're doing now?
What?
I'm out of cigarettes.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks. Where's Jack?
Down the hall.
You're kidding.
You mean with the what's-her-name's roommate? With Sally's roommate?
Edna. That's right. Don't worry about it, though. I can handle it.
I'll see you later.
Bye.
Bye. Hey, wait a minute. Nobody owns me. Nobody. I'm a free agent.
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, you got that look in your eye, honey.
The hell do you want, Jack?
The hell do I want? I want you to butt out. That's what I want. I don't like the feeling I get around here.
You the one to talk about feelings.
What? What are you talking about, Edna? Huh? She don't mean nothing to me, a broad like that. Nothing.
Not to you, maybe.
Julian, this is something I say only one time.
Say what?
friend and he's my partner. He's a cold son of a bitch.
I tell you what else he is. He's a meat grinder. But I guess every now and then you get a little stupid, huh?
Make our move, brother. Jesus, what's this stuff made out of?
I don't know, I gave it a pretty good shot. Stand back, because this time we're coming through, partner.
Head, Kim, what's your idea?
It's cold. Man, is it cold. Get ready for the loudest alarm you've ever heard.
What's the matter with it?
The damn cement duction. What's the matter? Nothing.
Silent alarm.
Well, let's not sit here. They know we're here downstairs.
Where the hell is everybody?
I don't know.
This place should be crawling with cops.
I want to go back and ask. I got a plane to catch.
Oh, you feel funny.
Beautiful baby, huh?
Oh, my God. never in my life seen any. I mean, I saw it in the case, but could I hold it?
Sure, you can hold it while I'm here. You want to hold it, huh?
Baby,
that is a diamond.
Unbelievable.
Oh,
that's not real.
Beautiful?
That can't be real.
Oh. It's real, and they're all ours. Oh.
God, you guys did it. You really did it. You're famous.
Watch it, Murphy.
Oh! Won't be mom's.
Great show, Vex, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, sir. Let's see if I can kiss that diamond right over there, baby.
Huh? You can do it.
Aquamarine on a diamond? Hey, all right.
You make that shot?
Show me that shot.
You're kidding me.
Aquamarine for that in. Hey, well, right up there, cowboy. Let's see if I can hit that diamond. A diamond on a diamond. Oh, and I got the aquamarine.
I used to be a champ at this when I was a kid.
What, the champ of Illinois, huh?
No, man, just...
Number 11. Place your bets. What is it? It's 11. Yay. Come 11. Ooh, one more shot. Oh, hang on, baby. Oh.
Look at that. When the light hits it, it looks like it's going to explode.
Oh.
You know, bitches, those guys at the museum didn't have this kind of imagination, did they?
Looks like a little atomic bomb going off.
Ooh, it's quite a unique toy. Quite unique.
Oh. How about some smoke?
Go get it, Mama.
Yeah.
Hey, what are you doing?
Just cleaning up.
My place.
Well, a search warrant means search.
Good.
But you could save him the trouble.
So where are the goddamn jewels?
Oh, honey, come on.
You know one thing I noticed about your friend? He never says please. You tell me.
Oh, I'm not accusing you, Alan. It's just that you do interesting things, like buying a 44-foot boat, cash, $1,000 bills. Oh, and managing to be in New York the night of the robbery.
New York? Who says we're in New York?
Well, you used that phone to make reservations.
You tapped the phone.
You guys got a lawyer?
No, not yet.
Well, get a good one.
Hey, with the flowers. Hey, what is with the flowers, huh?
You wanted to see us, sir.
Hear about Miami? Our government friends blew it. Didn't check with us, didn't tell anybody. Just busted in there with the search warrant, turned the whole place upside down.
You don't mean it. No gems.
Hell, they didn't even find a collar button. Now look, I don't want anything like that happening to us, understand? I gotta prosecute this mess, and all I've got so far is a lot of half-assed evidence that wouldn't hold up in a kangaroo court.
Okay. Is it anything goes, or do we play by the book?
I want the stones back. Understand?
Hey now, Hopper, how you doing?
Nah, I told you someday.
Yeah, well, this ain't it.
Oh, I heard about your big lawyer from Texas. But did you hear about our judge?
Bail is set at $50,000 each.
Your Honor, did I understand the court to say $50,000 each?
Each.
Perhaps the court would entertain a motion.
Mr. Avery, the court is well aware of your reputation, and I know you're not easily intimidated. But then neither am I.
But still, Your Honor, the district attorney has no real evidence.
I'm going to interrupt you, Mr. Avery, because you do not particularly please this court. Bail stands.
Mr.
$50,000. That doesn't seem to bother you too damn much.
He doesn't have to pay it.
That's the point. Hamlet's one of their judges. Now I'll go out and get one of mine.
$1,500 per bail, that's not too painful.
Lunch money. Avery, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Joe?
Yeah.
Murphy, please. What is this shit? Where is this pit, man?
What is all this?
Let's get the federal rep. New York State Warrant.
For what?
Four counts. Breaking into the museum, breaking out again, grand larceny, possession of burglary tools.
Well, now you see how it's going to go, don't you? Double arrest, trumped up charges, jacked up bail. Believe me, it's only just begun.
We can afford it.
It was only the first day, and it's already cost you $3,000.
Plus your fee.
Plus my fee here. Now we go to New York for arraignment. Who knows what's waiting for us up there?
How's it look, Avery?
Well, first we play the bail game again. That means you're stuck here for probably another day.
Avery, how the hell does it look, man?
Well, you're innocent. All my clients are innocent. But if you're smart, you'll keep the big stones handy. I mean the important ones.
Including the Star of India?
Especially the Star. Why does that surprise you?
Old time had plans for that one.
Forget it.
Hey, Avery. What about Jenny? I haven't heard about her since the bust.
Now, Miss Eaton, I'm going to ask you once more. Because it's pretty hard to believe, you know? I mean, you flew all the way down here with that thing on your lap and you never once peeked.
I never even tried. I think it was locked anyway.
The thing of it is, we know the jewels were in there. And you admit you carried it on the plane with Alan Cohn and Jack Murphy.
Yes, because that's what happened.
Yeah, we got a name for that. Interstate transportation of stolen property. It's a federal offense. Carries a stiff penalty. It also makes you an accessory to the crime itself. You understand that?
I didn't do anything.
Okay. What's the word? You find the stones yet?
No.
No idea.
Latest guess is somewhere in the bottom of the Atlantic. Persistent little bastards, aren't they?
Huh?
Persistent, lonely bastards. We lost them, brother. We're alone.
Like I keep telling you, people just don't look up.
Now, Miss Eaton, let me tell you what's going to happen to you. Tomorrow you fly back to New York and go before the grand jury. There's some questions they want to ask you. All right, I'll start this way. Remember those charges I told you about? You don't want to go to jail, do you?
No.
Okay. When they ask you if you saw the jewels in the briefcase, just tell them yes.
No.
Damn it! You saw those jewels!
Okay, but you knew they were in there, right?
No!
Aquamarine, faceted stone, 400 carats.
Are you still there, huh? Hey, your boys really blew this one. The Midnight Star, a mere 116.57 carats. The DeLong Ruby, 100.32 carats.
Getting all this, fellas? I know you're thorough, but I'd hate to have you miss anything.
Yeah, like engraved emerald, 87.64 carats.
Wait a minute, Jack. Tell your friend Arnie where it was.
In the waste paper basket, you dummy, the one you had your foot on!
You guys can search my place anytime. Except I wish you'd learn to put things back where you found them.
Were you brought up in a garbage dump?
Hey, Alan! What do you think it's gonna cost us to get out of this mess, huh?
Hell, I don't know. Probably everything we got. I mean, if it goes on,
You mean if we don't sell the crystal diamond 15.37 carats? Why, look here. The Star of India, 563.35 carats.
Jack, you know what I think we should do? We should fence the small stuff. But don't bother coming by, Arnie. Because we ain't got it on us.
Hey, you know those guys that were tailing us? Well, we lost them.
Oh, come on, Jack. You want to get those boys in trouble?
You're the gentleman who called.
Come on, Max, don't give me that. I need some money.
You came alone?
Hell yes, alone. What do you think I am?
What do you think I am?
I think you're the man with the money. My shoebox is empty, you know?
Well, you like this place here? I can lease it here, but that's all I can do.
Hey, Max. Don't give me that crap. Now, Jack and I are broke. We need some money.
Yesterday, they pulled the walls out of my house. My car and repair shop getting put back together. I've got to find a new place to live.
Shit, the heat's that bad. They reached out all the way to you.
Nothing moves in this town now, Alan. Not a thing. Even if you had a piece of glass from Woolworth's, you'd be stuck with it. That's how bad they want those stones.
They won't find them.
Look, Max, I don't mean the star, the big stones. But you gotta fence the small ones.
Goodbye, Alan.
Jack Murphy.
Murph the Surf, they call me. I'd like you to meet a very dear friend of mine, Mr. Alan Kewen. Now, there's been a lot of nasty rumors going around this town about us, and I'd like you to know they're not true, not any of them.
We're just a couple of innocent little beach boys out for a quiet night in the town, right?
And to show you that our hearts are in the right place, I'd like to buy the house around. All right. But first, a word from our sponsor.
I'd like you to meet our escorts. Man over there with the square-looking suit on.
Well, that's an old friend of mine. That's Special Agent Arnie Hokum. Yeah, I guess you can tell he works for the government. Standing next to him, the gentleman with his eyes sort of close together. Why, that's Sergeant Hopper McGee of the local gendarme. Well, I want you to make him feel right at home, folks. So how about it, huh? How about it?
You gotta buy the whole damn house a drink.
Style is style, baby.
Style is nothing without cash.
I thought we were about to come in just a minute.
That's if old Bucks is right for change and that cash box isn't empty.
Junior!
Hey, baby.
What's going on, man?
All right.
Hey, Duffy. Hey, Murph. Hey, Murph. Hey,
Spike, how's the business?
As long as I got my angels looking complete. How will it be?
They have some vodka on the rocks.
Rocks? Sure thing. You gotta be with you.
Hey, where's Alan?
Hallelujah.
Hi there, Alan. That really was a good try back at that club.
You said someday. I gotta give you credit.
Forget the credit. I want half.
Yeah.
All these people here. I think they're having a good time.
It looks to me like they're having a ball.
Well, sure. And you know why? I'll bet you $100 that they're married. I mean, most of them.
Oh, aren't you the optimist?
But not to each other. You know what marriage is to these people? Nothing. They don't understand it. They don't even know what commitment is.
Where the hell have you been? Ask Copper, if you can find him.
Hey now, Alan.
Well, how'd it go?
I had to split it with Hopper. What?
Tell me, Cole, you want half? I'm getting half.
Oh, that's really funny. Yeah, I think I'll go hang myself.
You're not hard to find. Who's that?
Oh, just this girl I know.
Hey, Jenny. No idea how I missed you.
Listen, I'm gonna have to cut you loose. See, I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to go to prison, you know. It's going to be a lot of grief. I just can't see you benefiting from this relationship in any way.
You've decided?
Yeah. I got this deal worked out. I'm going to buy you a new car. I'm going to get you this job running a bar. And I mean, you're really going to be set up.
That's the word, all right.
Hell, Jenny, what else can I do? You know, I mean, I don't know how to handle these kind of things. It's over, it's over. Come on.
Said with feeling. I called you a meat grinder once. I should have used more imagination.
Jenny, I have a lot of respect for you. That's why I talk to you this way, because I know you can take it. Besides, I don't see you trying to fight it.
You read me like a book, don't you?
No, I played straight with you. Because I always remember one thing my old man said. You can't break a promise you never made.
I'm going to try and remember that.
I think it's time for me to go.
How you been?
I've been around. I was gonna come back in a couple of days.
Where's BJ?
I hear there was a note.
Police have it. Said, "Dear Jack, I guess this is what you want. The last thing I can do for you. I love you."
Poor kid. I called. I called down. What'd I do? Alan, I never told the chick I loved her. Because I didn't. It was a need, really. A very weird need. She was so strong. Very strange relationship.
Gentlemen, let's play us some showdown poker. Now, the stakes are as follows. 31 years for a conviction. That's 31 years each. Versus 1 year. 1 year for a guilty plea and the return of the 12 major stones. Now, that's a plea to one count of burglary. All other charges are dropped.
Forget it.
Those are the stakes. 31 against one.
You say showdown. You ready to go to trial?
You bet we are. And here's our hand. clothing you wore when you broke into the museum.
What?
That's right. Matching fibers brought in the museum itself, adhering to the corners of display cases, the windowsill, and so on. What we have here is glass, ground into the soles. Matches exactly the glass, the special glass used by the museum for the display cases.
Bullshit.
Bullshit? The gloves you wore during the break-in. Book on the jewels. Guide to the museum. Floor plan of the gym room. Various burglar tools.
Well,
Robert.
Avery, I'm telling you, every single thing we used in the robbery, everything we bought, everything, I put into a bag and dumped it in the East River.
Well, then where did all that stuff come from?
Hell, don't ask me.
You mean they sold to the mine?
You had to.
You still want to fight it?
You goddamn right. You think I'm gonna let those jerks get away with that, right?
Said 1 year, didn't he?
1 year.
It's good enough for me.
What?
It's never gonna end, Murphy. Even if we get off, it's never gonna end. Not now, not 30 years from now, not ever. They're gonna hound us every day, day and night, until they get back their goddamn stones. Don't you realize that?
You crazy. You son of a bitch. Nothing gets to you, does it? Nothing moves you. You don't wise up. You don't wake up. You don't care about anything. What are you talking about, Jenny? Hey, the chick killed herself. That's her business, man. You walked all over her, you dirty bastard. You were the one who wanted to steal the freaking star. I told you we were gonna get busted. I told you that, but I did it anyway. I hung right in there because you wanted it. For me, sure. Yeah, whatever that is.
What?
Alan Kewin. At least with me, everything's up front. You know who I am. When did the Alan Kewin ever show himself? When did you ever show your real face? You know something, Alan? I don't think there is one. I don't think there's anything real about you when you give me that crap about Jenny.
That's so.
You bet your sweet ass it is.
Avery, you tell those lying bastards upstairs that I'm gonna take their deal.
God damn it, man, we could kill them in court!
So what?
Avery, what is an outcome? We could buck them?
Well, I can take that case apart. I think I can demolish it.
You think?
Great, I like that. Does that mean you work for free? Are you volunteering your services?
Well, hardly.
Then screw you, Avery, you hear me? Screw you. Listen, Kewin, you could have said no. Anytime. You didn't have to tie up with me. Nobody held a freaking gun to your head. You could have went your own way, but you didn't.
You didn't? Right. But not anymore. Because I want to tell you something. I am the only one who knows where those stones are. Avery, it looks like you're stuck with a couple of bullets because that's all that's left. Now, you get your ass up there and make that deal.
It's them. Here they come.
Hey, you got anything to say?
Yeah, I think we got screwed.
Back over you two?
Oh, I don't know. Does this change your mind about anything?
Hey, now that you're caught, you learn your lesson, you're going to go straight?
Eventually.
How about you, Jack? What are you going to do next?
Nothing left to do, is there?
What does that mean?
Well, how are you going to top the star? What are you going to do for an encore?
He'll think of something.